Hey guys, back. I managed to score a Sony reel-to-reel stereo cassette deck. The model number is TC-252D. It's a solid state, which I probably wouldn't have mattered if it was tubes, because I would have liked it even more. But anyway, it powers up, which is good. It looks like it's been dropped. The case needs a little bit of repair. You can see it's separated there. Not a big deal. But one thing it doesn't do is there's no motor action. So we're going to open it up and see if we can't get it going. The pinch roller is not seized. And it comes up nicely and nice and tight against the tape. So that's a plus. Be interesting to see what's on these reels. But like I said, nothing, there's no motor action, so I don't know if it's maybe it's a starter cap on the motor or if it's the motor itself, so that's what we're going to find out when we open it up. Some hefty screws holding this together. Don't make them like that anymore. There might be two more on the bottom. I'll try one-handing it here. It doesn't look like it. So what we're going to do is remove the reels without damaging them. It'll be interesting to see what's on them, if we can get it working. There we go. I'll set that somewhere where it can't get damaged. I'll put it over here. Okay. We should just be able to just slide this right out of the case. So I'm going to need two hands for that. Okay, to get the rest of the guts out, you need to take the face plate off, which I'm working on now. I'm trying to figure out where the other screw is. Like this, the top is free. It's just the bottom, isn't it? I'm missing something here. Anyway, yeah, so you'll have to remove this face plate. As you can see, when I power it up, that motor would be spinning right about now, which it's not. Everything's still there. The gears aren't totally rotted. Still some life left in them by the feel of it. So if I can get that motor to spin, this will work. Okay, the bottom's being held by the 2 feet. They screw right through to the base of the frame of the unit. So we just remove the feet. And that should free it up, basically. Oh, door. Okay, sorry about that, guys. And delivery. Okay, here we go. Here's the starter cap for the motor. That could be the problem right there. We'll have to do some tests. There's actually something underneath there that we'll have to take a look at, too. I don't think it's the motor itself. It doesn't look to be blackened or anything like that. It looks pretty clean, actually. So we'll do some readings off the obvious stuff, like the voltage and everything else. Could be something simple like the switch for the motor is gone when you switch it over. If you don't know until you test it. That's what we're going to do now. We need to do some quick testing and then we'll see if we can find the problem. Well, found the problem, guys. It's this cap here. It's rated for 120 UF, 500 volts. It is toast. That bridges from there to there. But basically, the starter cap is good because I got this to spin. But basically the AC comes in and it goes over here and then bridges across this cap here and then it goes over to this side and to the board. I probably could run it without, but I'm going to see if I have one of these laying around that I can just quickly solder in and give it a test. Well, that was the problem, guys. Both of these capacitors are basically dried right out, so I tested this one on it. And it actually works, so we're just warming up the soldering iron and see if we can't get this thing to play. Well, okay guys, so it does work. I found these caps just smooth out the AC, so you don't really need them. I will pick some up from New Tech when I get around to it. But it is working, and it's got some trippy music on it. It takes you right back to the 60s. There's no speaker, so I'll just hopefully don't annoy anybody on YouTube with the copyright, but we'll try it. I don't know if you can hear that. Yeah, it's pretty quiet, but it does have a perfect sound, so we're gonna basically take the case and re-glue it and hook it up to the stereo. See how it sounds. Well, here you go. It's all hooked up. Could use a little bit more work, but it's getting there. Sounds pretty good considering. Fast forwards. One thing it is missing though is I think there's little caps that go on here that hold the reels on because they don't lock. So that's a bit of an issue. But it's good to go. Later.